It was probably a joke, but I got a comment on the Persona Waifus video from one Solidus Snake saying, MK Waifu tier list when? And you know what? Yeah, let's do that. So I'm using Perv Garden's Mortal Kombat female character tier list. Sorry for doing this to it, but this is going to be my style for any potential future waifu tier list videos. Yeah, MK is the kind of series where you don't really think of it as like waifu-ish. I guess because it's not Japanese, I feel like there's not as many Western franchises where people will look at waifus. But let's get on with this. Now, I did a little looking at this before, and there's a couple of things to note. One is that it's kind of amusing to me every time you get one with no real uniformity between the images. You know, here's one from a cutscene, here's some promo art, here's a character's render. You know, there's no uniformity, and I just find that amusing for some reason. But the other thing is, for some reason, Jade is on here twice, and so is Sindel. Now, I'm not sure when about this was made, whether this was made, you know, post-11, and that this was supposed to be a statement on how different Sindel is. But if that's the case, then is that indicating that the creator feels the same about Jade, that she went through a massive shift in character? Probably not the case. I'm probably just reading too much into it, but I'm going to use these two Sindels to represent the two characters. So, you know, that's the spectrum right there. That shows you just how this is going to go. You know, we kind of start from the edge and work our way inwards. And in a similar vein, yeah. So, to briefly explain for someone who's not familiar for some reason, Sindel is my second favourite MK character. Melina's my favourite, but I don't know if I'll necessarily consider Melina a top-tier waifu. She's a great character, but as a waifu, I don't know, because there is a difference. Although, when looking at waifu material, how much you like the character obviously is going to have an impact on that viewpoint. So, yeah, Sindel's up there. She's a loving wife and mother. She wasn't always, but she has become a better person. And, you know, self-improvement is a good thing. And then you look at the MK11 version, which is what the 2011 version represents. And they're not the same character. Well, MK11 and 2011 Sindel are supposed to be the same character. But you know how MK continuity is. They just completely fucked it all up. And so they are completely different characters. They have completely different backstories. The narratives do not align at all. But, you know, I've talked about the ruination of Sindel enough. You know, I've got a playlist and fucking Sonic Heart XD made a joke about it. And I'm like, yeah, maybe I've gone a little far in some places. But you know what? It needed to be talked about. Fuck NetherRealm. Sindel was great. And they ruined her. Someone actually made a comment a few hours ago on the most recent Sindel video where they said that they used to be against me on the subject of Sindel, but they've come around now that they've started to think about it, and they've concluded that the new Sindel isn't even a good character. She's just a really flat villain, and she is. You know, so she's in trash not just because, you know, she stabbed her husband in the back. Possibly literally. She definitely stabbed him in the chest. So she's obviously really bad waifu material, but also she's a shit character, and so is Kronika. You know, Kronika's a petulant child who cries because she really does feel like she's supposed to be some kind of commentary on fans who don't like the newer games or the newer story. You know, the story didn't play out the way I wanted it to, so I'm going to change the timeline and make things better. You know, it's like, she's like the Superboy Prime or the Golden Age Superman from Infinite Crisis of MK. And it's really weird. But yeah, Kronika's trash. So I'm still trying to figure out what the point of the two Jades is. And I can't think of anything to use one to represent compared to the other. So I'm just going to pick my preferred design for Jade of the two, because that one's not, I just don't like that design that much. And I'm not going to go on a crusade and go, bruh. MK9 designs, bruh. Sexist, bruh. No, I'm not going to be that kind of person, but it was a bit much, I think. So I'm going to use this one to represent Jade and see what I can think of for that one. So Jade is a character I never really cared much about until her MK11 design came along, because the model they chose for her to do the face scanning is fucking gorgeous. But at the same time, MK11's the game that took her character in a weird direction, because she used to be a character who, she was a satellite character. She revolved around Kitana and Sindel. But now she just revolves around Kotal, which is more flat, because she's not revolving around the royal family, you know, Kitana, her best friend, Sindel, her queen, her home realm and all that. Now it's just around Kotal because she wants his blue painted cock. And that was ruinous for her character. I guess I'll put her in top tier for now, because again, she is gorgeous. And I guess if you're looking at it from the perspective of what she will do for her mans, yeah, she's probably up there, because her and Kotal, she clearly loves Kotal a lot, even though, you know, it came out of nowhere. And yeah, Twindel's like that, you know, if she likes you enough, she'll stick by you. But, you know, fuck Twindel. Not literally. She don't deserve that. Frost is bad. I'm not going to get into it. I've said it enough about how she could have been something. There's not much to say about Kira, you know? She didn't really have much room to shine. They didn't do much with her, unfortunately. Because a big part of the issue is... I think the 3D era characters are largely going to go into here. Because part of the issue is those characters didn't get much time to really make much of an impact beyond the designs and movesets. Because the newer games are so focused on nostalgia for the original trilogy. I mean, you look at all the 3D era characters and how many of them have actually returned in a game as a fighter. There's Kenshi, Bo Raicho, and I think that's it. You know, you had some cameos here and there in the comics, mostly to die, and sometimes the characters get referenced, but that's it. It's just too focused on the older games, and the rosters are very samey, which is saying, you know, you could go from Deadly Alliance to Deception, and like six characters on that roster returned. Everyone else was a new character or a character from an older game. So they would take risks and stuff. They would do stuff like that. Now it's just, when's the last time we had an MK game that didn't feature the full playable roster of MK1 plus Kitana and Kung Lao? That was DCU, and that was only because they had a smaller roster than usual and had to split it with DC. Otherwise, yeah, I'm sure all these characters would have been on there. Kind of funny because Chameleon and Chameleon are from the classic era because they debuted in Trilogy, but they don't get to come back and do stuff. It sucks. Tanya's quite a good character. She has been fleshed out a bit. I think the reading of her character as being loyal to Idenia and wanting to see it protected, I think is really good. I think that's a great direction to take her character. And her relationship with Melina, two different ways you can go with it. You could have it be an actual loving relationship, or she could be manipulating Melina, but there's a lot you can do with that. And if you go with the loving route, then yeah, you know, they at least want to fuck, you know, and that's something, you know. Tanya wants to fuck Melina, but not in like a gross way, the way it's normally done in MK with the villains. No, Sindel's like, yeah, I'm going to have fucking breeding slaves. And you're thinking, God, I hope that old timelines don't still exist in MK. Because maybe they do, because you know, Fire God Liu Kang shows up from the timeline that was before the one that Shang Tsung, Nightwolf, and Fujin created. So maybe the timeline still exists. But if they do, then that means that in the Aftermath timeline, Johnny Cage and Sonya Blade are doomed to be breeding slaves. And that's fucked up. That was unnecessary. You know, people talk about the objectification of the women and that, but no one complains about that. The fact that Johnny and Sonya are going to be forced to just fuck constantly to produce slaves for Sindel. What the fuck? This isn't Game of Thrones, guys. Jesus Christ. Sonya's one that's tricky to place because she's not a particularly good mother, but that doesn't make her a bad character because her reasons are understandable. And there are times when, you know, she and Johnny are genuinely cute together. You know, the start of MK11, which is shocking considering the intros in that game and the way they were portrayed in the comic by Sean, who co-wrote MK11, where their relationship is horrible. And she's also let down by being voiced by Ronda Rousey, because Ronda Rousey, ooh, that's bad. I hate Ronda Rousey's performance. The person herself doesn't seem much better, to be honest. So I am going to place her in good. She's fine. So what do you say we find another bad character, another bad one? How about Jackie Briggs? I feel like if Jackie hadn't come back for MK11 and had just been an ex, it would have been Don't Care. But the fact she's been in two games with the cinematic story modes and still has very little character to her, very little to make her stand out, especially when the other combat kids are at least distinct in terms of fighting style. Yeah, Jackie's bad. I honestly would have cut her from the roster and gone with someone else. Supposedly, Ed Boon said that she's a popular character, and I don't know where he said that. And if he did, I don't know where he got that information from. He might be lying. That is possible. Well, I have to put in fucking Trash by default because she's a child. If you consider her a waifu, then you're bad. This tier list I'm using is not a waifu one, it's just for the female characters, not waifus. So it's not like, you know, putting Caroline and Justine onto one of them, because that'd be fucking trash. But even just as a character, you know, there's no way this character would even go above Don't Care. There's no way she'd be above that, because Fer and Tora are just nothing characters. No, and unlike Jackie, it's hard to be angry about that because they didn't come back. The team basically acknowledged that they were shit characters and did nothing with them. Maybe it was because the amount of work they would have needed to do to put Tor in there, you know, with his unique innards because he's so big. They would have needed a completely unique damage model, and that's why there's so little variety in body types in MK, especially in the newer ones. Fat characters, like super big roided out dudes, yeah, they can't be in the games. I mean, they won't even go to the effort of making sure that Devora's skinless model has her actual chitin feet and not human ones. So why the fuck would they bother making a full interior model for Tor? Are you mad? Speaking of Devora, yeah, I don't get the appeal, I really don't. She's just awful and she gets way too much of a fucking push. I mean, it says a lot that, you know, Cassie Cage in MKX beat Shinnok and Elder God at his most powerful that we've ever seen him. And somehow Devorah has more of an unwarranted push than Cassie, but she just fucking kills everyone. Fuck you. Speaking of Cassie, if it was MKX, she would go in probably Don't Care. And then you look at MK11, and I feel like she has less personality, but I like her more. I don't know, I can't really explain it. But I'm going to put her in good, at least for now, because she's a good character. There's a lot you could do with her in terms of her potential. Should I have just done a normal MK characters tier list? Maybe another time. For now, I'll just do this as waifus, and then maybe I'll rank the characters as characters. Yeah. So this one's going to be the characters as wife material. And so, if you look at it from that perspective, yeah, I guess. Because she's untrustworthy. Again, as a character, she's good, but she's untrustworthy. And so, Cassie could be fun to be around. So, I think she would go up there in the top tier. So would Kitana. Cetrion, no, because she would sell you out to her mother. Although, she does seem to... Well, she would care about you until her mother tells her that you're going to be erased, and she'll be complicit in your erasure and replacement with a new incarnation of yourself. So, yeah, fuck her, right? Fuck that bitch. Also trash tier, Shiva, because she's also a bad character now. I mean, I would have put Shiva in Don't Care prior to MK11, but you look at her in 11, and she thinks she's so much better because of her race and sex. It's weird. She's like, Shokan are the strongest motherfuckers. It's like, yeah, that's why Shokans have never won a fight in this timeline before this game. It's not Shokan superiority, Shiva. You're the only one who ever won a fight, you fucking fool. And if the Shokan really were superior, then how is it that Sonya Blade in Home of Human was able to rip Kintaro's head off his shoulders? You tell me, Shiva. You fucking tell me. And it's funny because she has an intro where she says that women are the inherently stronger sex. I think it's to Kano. I feel like if that had been said the other way, the character would have been challenged and presented as the bad guy, but not Shiva. Shiva gets an unwarranted amount of leeway for the horrible things she says and does. I can't stand her. Lee Mei cares about her people, so she's at least in good. She almost died in Deadly Alliance to save her people, and then she became a leader of her people in the new timeline, so she's definitely a caring person, as well as having a really good design in Deadly Alliance. Now with Melina, an interesting thing is that I don't think we've ever seen Melina betray someone. I think ironically, despite being created to be a doppelganger of Kitana and to take her place and imitate her, she's ironically possibly one of the most honest characters. It's really weird when you think about it. God damn it. I think it's just been proven that I ramble too much in these videos because I ran out of disk space and had to stop recording, but now I'm back and need to wrap this up as quickly as possible. So, I don't even know what I was talking about. Some bullshit, probably. Oh yeah, Melina being honest. So, if you treat her well, I think she actually could be good wife material. If you consistently treat her well. Because she seems to genuinely be into Tanya when you look at her intros. So, okay, I'll put her in good just because, if you know, I don't think Jade, Kitana, Sindel, like real Sindel, or Cassie would eat your throat. But, you know, Melina would. Look at that, I made an argument about Melina based on her character and not whether or not she has lips. Ho ho, I'm so good at this. And Serena's a good person. I'm going to put her in good simply because there is always the potential for Quan Chi to come in and mind control her to turn against you, as happened with her and Kuai Liang in the original timeline. Here's a question for you, right? If you're the kind of person who ships Serena, do you prefer to ship her with Bi-Han or Kuai Liang? That's the question. Do you prefer to ship her with the original brother or the younger one who she's then working with and possibly wants to help free his brother from his mind control under Quan Chi, which is somewhat similar to what happened to her, and then much more like what happened to her in Armageddon? So that's the question. I think this is pretty good. You know, we have Sindel, the true top tier best waifu, provably because she loved her husband, followed by characters who I think wouldn't be good partners, really good ones. Then these ones who would at least be good, but some of them have certain downsides. Lee Mei doesn't have particular downsides, but there's not enough about her character in the game to really say she's not been fleshed out enough. Characters who it's really hard to say anything about in terms of what they'd be like as waifu material because they have so little characterization. Ones who are bad characters or who are just likely to betray you. And then the trash, and you don't need to explain the trash because it's trash, you know? Trash goes in the incinerator. And then we have another Jade. There you go. Two Jades to be your waifu. I mean, why not? We'll just say this one is the classic Jade who was friends with Katana, and you got this one who is the one that's fucking Kotal. You know, obviously she has poor taste in men because she's with Kotal. You know, Kotal who fucked Devora, I remind you. But she's still a very caring person. Anyone will be lucky to have her as their wife, is what I'm saying. And that's kind of the important thing in waifu material. And that's it. Let me know if you want to see like a full character tier list for MK or more waifu things for other series. I mean, you know who's going to be best girl if you do Soul Calibur. I mean, if you don't know about that by now, what are you even doing here? You don't know me, bitch.